The Russian Pantsir-S1 air defense system has received a hypersonic missile. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed speeds of Mach 5. That's 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. Russia is seen to be at the forefront of hypersonic weapons development. It's said that it's deployed an HGV, or Hypersonic Glide Vehicle Avanguard, and a hypersonic ALBM, or Air-Launched Ballistic Missile Kinzhal. It's also been revealed that Pantsir-S1 will potentially receive other enhancements, also that will increase its firepower. Though it seems a natural progression for Russia to arm its well-known Pantsir-S1 air defense system with hypersonic missiles and upgrade its other capabilities, there's more to this story. In this video, Defense Updates reports on why and how Russia is upgrading its Pantsir-S1 after it failed against Israel's Air Force in Syria. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft or ship, and 3 days of premium account. The Pantsir-S1 missile system is a self-propelled, surface-to-air missile system. It's designed to provide point air defense of military, industrial, administrative installations against aircraft, helicopters, precision munitions, cruise missiles, and UAVs. Viewers may note that the S-400 missile defense system is also protected by Pantsir-S1. The Pantsir-S1 is mobile and uses wheeled or track chassis. Its fire control system includes a target acquisition radar and dual waveband tracking radar that operates in the UHF and EHF waveband. The detection range is 22 miles or 36 kilometers, and the tracking range is 17 miles or 28 kilometers for a target of 2 square meters or 22 square foot RCS. The system has a 360-degree coverage, and both the sensors use passive electronically scanned array. There's also an infrared radar that's capable of detecting, acquiring, and tracking targets even in low visibility conditions. Pantsir-S1 is unique as it's the first version of the Pantsir family air defense system that combines short to medium range surface-to-air missile and anti-aircraft artillery in a single platform. The surface-to-air missiles are the 1257E6 or 57E6E two-stage solid fuel radio command guided missile. The missiles are arranged into two groups of 6 sealed ready-to-launch container tubes on the turret. The missiles have a range of 20 kilometers or 12 miles, max speed of Mach 3.8, and carry a 20 kilogram high explosive fragmentation warhead. Anti-aircraft artillery is the two dual 2A38M 30mm autocannon guns that are fitted with 700 rounds. The crew can choose the kind of ammunition depending on the nature of the target, which includes high explosive fragmentation or armor-piercing rounds. The maximum rate of fire is 2,500 rounds per minute per gun. The cannon has a range of 2.5 miles or 4 kilometers. Theoretically, Pantsir-S1 has the capability of defending itself against any air-to-surface threat, but it proved to be wrong. Several of the Pantsir-S1 were provided by Russia to the Assad regime. In May 2008, Israeli Defense Forces released a video showing the destruction of a Syrian Pantsir-S1 which came as a big embarrassment for Russia. According to Israeli Defense Force, the decision to strike the Syrian Pantsir-S1 anti-air missile system was made after it opened fire on Israeli aircraft. IDF said in a statement, "The installation attacked by Israel's Air Force fired missiles at Israeli aircraft to shoot them down. The IDF will continue to act against anyone who tries to harm the state of Israel and its inhabitants." At that time, many Russian experts have put forth many theories. Atek Bizhev, former deputy commander-in-chief of the Russian Air Force, told Russian Today that there could be two possible reasons for the failure of Pantsir-S1 in protecting itself. One is that it had already used up its ammunition reserve. The other one is that it was simply turned off. It wasn't battle ready. He continued, "There can be no third option, as it wouldn't have let itself to be destroyed. When it's battle ready, it performs constant surveillance of enemy aircraft and has a very fast reaction time. It would have brought down those cruise missiles with either its cannons or own missiles." But these kind of explanations are suspect. Firstly, having no missiles left meant it launched all its missiles and yet failed to engage any target. Secondly, there's no reason why it would be turned off, since the Pantsir-S1 was in a war zone, tasked to protect the area from aerial threats. It was speculated that a saturation attack by the Israelis using Harop, Harpy 2 drones, or Delilah cruise missiles destroyed the system. The feat was repeated by the Israeli Air Force again, and this reinforced that Pantsir-S1 failed. Interestingly, the task of protecting the Russian military base in Syria was shifted from Pantsir-S1 to Tor-M2U, further indicating the existence of problems in the Pantsir-S1. Speaking to state-owned TASS Russian news agency, Valery Slugin, the chief designer for air defense systems at Shipanov Design Bureau of Instrument Making, said that the Pantsir-S is being armed with a new hypersonic missile. He told the media outlet, "There are two missiles that fight the entire range of targets. One is standard, while the other has been developed recently and is hypersonic. It can develop a speed of Mach 5 and more." Slugin said that the new missile will reach targets much faster, effectively increasing the rate of fire of the Pantsir-S, whose fire control system will be freed faster from the initial target to acquire and engage other targets. He added, "Besides, there is no need to load a large amount of explosives into the missile's warhead for the fragment's dispersal. The higher the impact speed, the greater the fragment's efficiency." The name of the hypersonic missile was not disclosed. It's also noted that Slugin did not identify whether the missile has been accepted into operational service or if instead it's still in the development and testing phase. Slugin discussed other changes being considered for the Pantsir missile system. For example, its transporting and loading vehicle, TLV, may become capable of firing missiles. Slugin stated, "We plan to develop a new support vehicle that will carry an even bigger payload. Transporting and loading vehicle may become a transporting combat vehicle. The vehicle will be able to engage targets based on data provided from the battery's main radar." Slugin said, "We can install a simplified control system. The vehicle will receive target designation from the main unit, but will fire missiles on its own. TLVs can carry up to 24 missiles, whereas the regular launcher unit has a maximum of 12. Russian military equipment export is a major source of revenue for the nation, and the Pantsir-S1 incident resulted in a massive PR disaster. It must be noted that unlike in the West, where media is able to highlight any shortcomings of the military system, in Russia, they're choked. This gave rise to the murmurs that many other Russian systems have significant flaws, but these have not got into the public domain. Another important aspect is that Israel didn't even need to employ the 5th generation F-35 stealth fighters, which were just acquired from the US at that time. So, overall, it can be said that Russia needed to do something about Pantsir-S1, and they responded. The hypersonic missile will increase lethality, as a fighter jet will have very little time to undertake evasive maneuvers. TLV enhancements will give it much more firepower, and it will come in very handy if faced with a saturation attack.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.